Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's go into some detail about the stereochemistry of alkene additions and see how we can avoid some common mistakes in drawing products. Here is a reaction you've likely seen before. This is a dibromination of cyclohexene. Dibrominations are anti-additions. So the product here has one bromine on the top face of the molecule and the other bromine on the bottom face. The reaction goes through a bromonium ion intermediate. One halogen forms the bromonium ion on one face of the alkene, and I've shown the top face here. And the other halogen, now a halide, a bromide anion, opens up the bromonium ion from the opposite face. That sets up the bromines on opposite faces on what was the alkene. Cyclic alkenes are perfect for highlighting this anti-addition because the ring has a clear top and bottom. When we look at this reaction on acyclic alkenes, the stereochemistry gets a bit more complex. These are two alkenes, two different alkenes. One is the Z alkene. We can add hydrogens to make everything more clear. The other is the E alkene with the hydrogens. We can draw the bromonium ion for the top alkene. It's kind of messy. But the first Br is definitely on the top face. The second bromine then comes from the bottom to give this product. We can add the hydrogens to make the stereochemistry more clear. Okay, how about the bottom? Let's do the same. The first bromine comes in from the top. Let's carefully keep everything else the same. The second bromine comes in from the bottom to give this product again, including the hydrogens, these two products, whoops, we don't need a negative charge there. These two products look different, but are they different? Yes, they are isomers of one another. They are diastereomers. The top structure is SR, and the bottom structure is SS. So the difference in stereochemistry in the starting materials, E and Z, translates to a difference in stereochemistry in the products. How interesting. Note that drawing the products requires some additional care. We had to keep the carbon chain still, keep all the carbons in the same place as the starting material in order to draw the products properly and then recognize the difference in stereochemistry. What happens if you are not careful with stereochemistry in these addition reactions? Here is the bottom reaction again. It is very common for students to count the carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Redraw the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then add the bromines in an anti-fashion. One up, one down. But this is not being careful. On the previous slide, we carefully kept the carbon chain in the same orientation. On this slide, we just drew the four carbons in a standard zigzag. What's wrong with this product? Well, the stereochemistry is wrong. The stereochemistry shown is what we obtained from the E alkene, which is different from the Z alkene that we have on this page. So there are two lessons here. First, the stereochemistry of the alkene does affect the stereochemistry of the addition product. Second, you need to be especially careful when drawing addition products from acyclic alkenes. Keep the chain atoms in the same positions from the starting structure to the product in order to minimize messing up the stereochemistry. Stereochemistry is a challenging topic, and I hope this video helped emphasize the importance of working carefully with stereochemistry in these addition reactions. Your questions are always welcome and encouraged in the comments section. Take care.